Mom tired of cleaning up after her messy kid stops giving a crap and goes on strike. Kids are messy. That's just part of the growing process. They don't understand why Lego has to go back in the box or why you can't just leave a box of paints on the floor for someone to step on and smear blue acrylic all over the carpets. And for many of us, our childhoods played out against an incessant soundtrack of our mums yelling their heads off about the amount of mess we made. But one mother has gone on strike and doesn't regret it. Heidi Hamm is a writer and mother of three who recently uploaded a picture of her children's messy playroom to explain why she was no longer going to clean it. "Today I shut a door on this," she writes. "For years I would spend a few minutes every night cleaning up after my kids. I would hate to calculate just how many hours of my life have been spent picking up toys. A heck of a lot." Heidi says that keeping her house clean is one of the few things she feels she has control over, but that her messy kids don't give a damn about trying to keep their environment clutter-free. "I don't get it. Clearly, they are lacking in the clean gene department. I don't know how many times I have had the same conversation with them. Me, how can you stand it? You can't even walk in here. Kids, yes we can. We just play hopscotch around the toys." One day, Heidi's husband found her on her hands and knees, color coordinating discarded Lego pieces. "Why don't you just shut the door?" he asked. I stared up at him. It's possible it was more of a glare. I had been expecting him to join me on the floor, sifting through the mountain of Lego. Instead, he offered me those seven words. Apparently, it was all I needed. I got up and closed the door. And the door has remained closed ever since. She says that turning her back on their clutter is a form of self-care. These days everybody is talking about how self-care is so important when you're a parent. And it is. It's so easy to lose yourself in taking care of everyone else. But self-care? Yeah, it's not so easy. It takes time and energy and asking for help. Mum shares brilliant trick for soothing a crying baby in seconds. 14 practical things to do when you find out you're pregnant. 12 things you shouldn't do if you've been up with the baby all night. Self-care is closing a door. And it seems that it's been effective at actually getting the children to take responsibility for their playroom after all. They clean the room once a week. The rest of the time, it might look like a bomb site, but it's not Heidi's space or problem anymore. More, how growing up poor affects your attitude to money as an adult. More, 9 of the best thank you presents for teachers